The Memphis Area Master Gardener Spring Fling 2019 is almost here, Ms. Kim. And I understand you're going to be a part of that event.
Yes.
You'll be talking about ferns, right?
Yes.
Okay. What exactly will you be doing?
Thank you for having me.
Oh, sure.
I'm going to do a fern propagation demonstration on how to get more ferns from your existing plants. Ferns are very ancient plants. They are vascular plants, so they do have roots and they do pull up their nutrients and water through a vascular system, which they are the first in the evolutionary chain that do that.
Wow.
So, but they do not have flowering parts or cones, so they're evolutionary less advanced. They do have two basic forms of the plant. You have the sporophyte, which is this is what you see out in the woods, and it's spore bearing, which is what sporophyte means. And then you have the gametophyte, which is in here. And if you can see, it's the little green mossy looking, it's not moss, but that is the gametophyte generation.
Wow.
And so in order to propagate these, you can either divide them by splitting them, wait till the crown splits, or some are have rhizomes, so you can split out the rhizomes. But what we're going to do is take the spores and propagate that way. So these are some immature spores on this plant. And the reason I know they're immature is because they're green.
Okay.
Generally, what you want to look for are either black or brown spores. And this usually is going to happen midsummer, late summer.
Okay.
So that's when you collect. And you can collect them and store them for a little while. What we do to collect them is you will cut off this piece, the frond, when it's ready. And then this is kind of what it looks like. It dries. And what you can do is take off the individual little leaflets or pinna. And I put them into an envelope and close it up and leave them in that way for a couple of days. And then I just kind of flick it like this. And the spores dry, the sori on the back, the little caps, dry out, and then they dehiss and the spores come out. And so what you will get down in the very bottom of the envelope, and it's very fine, which is good because they're windborne, and so in order in the wild in nature to get them, they have to hit the wind and then land in a spot that's optimal for the growing conditions. Okay. What we will do once you get your fern, labeling. If you want to know what they are, because on these my labels are gone. So what I've done here is just put a number one several places on here, and then I'll have a notes that I take that have the actual name written down, maybe the date that I started them and possibly where I collected them, you know, Dixon Gardens or whatever. So, and then what you're going to do, so you can use any kind of basically clear container that has a lid. And what we will use is a sterile mix, and I'm using seeding mix, which is just peat ground very fine with a little bit of vermiculite in it. It is sterile, though. You don't want to use garden soil unless you sterilize it.
Right.
You can do that by baking it in the oven, and I don't recommend it because it really stinks. It's easier just to go by seed mix.
Okay.
You can get it at any nursery, big box stores.
Okay.
And so you put just a thin layer down in the bottom like this, and then what you do, and it also has no fertilizer in it. You do not want a fertilizer.
No fertilizer.
So, no fertilizer. And then you take, this is horticultural grade vermiculite.
Okay.
So, you take a little bit of this, and vermiculite, one of the properties, and while we're using it, is because it retains moisture. So once the germination process of the spores starts, you don't want it to stop.
Okay.
And so what I do is just really sprinkle it to one side, like that, so you kind of have half and half. So then what I'm going to do is you take distilled water, again, because it's been sterilized, basically, and I will moisten it. And this is good also for people to see, because once the water hits the vermiculite, it kind of jumps. It's really kind of cool. So, but I'll you just kind of mist it a little bit. Once you get this going, you put the lid on and you just can, you don't have to keep misting it unless it really dries out. But the lid on it, the condensation, will just keep it moist.
So you don't have to put that much water, just as long as it gets a little moisture.
Just a little moisture in there. And what I kind of do is make sure that you can kind of see where the moisture is showing up, because it gets darker.
Okay.
So then what you do is you just take your little spores. I'm going to pull the other pieces out that have the sori on them, And then you will basically take it and just drop it in there like this. And it, like I said, it's a very fine dust. And the only way you really know you got it is it's gone out of your, it's, also if you're really wanting to keep certain, species or cultivars separate, I suggest doing them one at a time because they are very fine and they will blow. And I've done in the wind, and so you'll get cross contamination.
Okay.
So do one set and then get rid of those and then do your next ferns. So then you just put the lid on it, close it up like this, and put it in a window or a well-lit room. You want it warm, but you don't want direct sunlight on it.
Okay.
And what you should see, even within a a short amount of time, are condensation droplets on top of on the lid. And then that's the way it stays moist.
Gotcha.
Okay,
gotcha.
The next thing you need to do is go away on vacation for like 2 weeks at least before you check on it. Because the first thing that people say is, oh, mine didn't work. I just came back and there's all this green stuff growing all over. That's what you want.
It.
So like I showed you before, the green stuff there is the next stage of the plant. So this is a sporophyte. Those are the gametophytes. And it's actually this little flat heart-shaped disc. And then underneath are the gametes, the male and female.
Okay.
And they get together. And the next thing you know, you've got little ferns like this. So the next thing you would do is to move them up. And I usually just, because they're still so small, I would just move them again into germinating mix. I don't usually put plants that I'm gonna put out in the garden in perlite, in a mix that has perlite. And then once that grows on and you've got a, your plant is more established, then I would maybe put it in a bark based mix and grow it on a little bit before you plant it. But you do have to be patient, like I said, because these were started about a year ago. So it takes about a year to get them to this point. And it's different for different ferns, but that's your basic. When you once you get them up in, like this, you can start slowly, you can take the lid off to check them, and then you can kind of pull the lid like this. You want to gradually expose the new little fern to dry air.
Okay.
So you may need to pull the lid off and then mist it a little bit, and then gradually, maybe over
open
a week to
a
2 weeks,
more.
You can open it up more, and it gets used to being out in the bright sunlight.
Okay.
But that's fern propagation.
That's fern propagation.
Yes.
Thank you, Ms. Kim. We appreciate
you're
that demonstration. All right.
Thanks for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, please click the subscribe button below.